Hi guys, today we'll go with the types of vectors. So in that, the first one is zero vector. Zero vector is nothing but vector whose initial and a terminal points coincide is called a zero vector. Is nothing but there will be a vector. Vector is nothing but what? It is a quantity having a both magnitude and a direction. So in this, a vector whose initial and a terminal point. So here I'll state this is what the initial point. So from here it will move the vector. Okay. And it will coincide with the initial point only. Now you just consider this. This is the initial point. From this, vector will move. And again, it will end up with the same initial point only. That means a initial and a terminal point will coincide. Then such a vector is called as a zero vector. And it is denoted as a zero vector like this. Is it clear? Otherwise, we can say that it may be regarded as having any direction. It may be any direction. The vectors can be written as AA vector or BB vector represented for a zero vector. Is it clear? So next is unit vector. Unit vector is nothing but it is a vector whose magnitude is a unity, is nothing but one unit, is called as a unit vector. Is it clear? The unit vector in a direction of a given vector. If I consider a vector as a EA, then it is denoted as a cap. A unit vector is denoted by a cap. So, how we can say about the unit vector is nothing but it is a vector whose magnitude is a unity, is nothing but it is a one unit, and such a vector is called as unit vector. Next is coinsial vector. You can consider two or more vectors, okay, having the same initial point, then are called as a coinsial vector. For example, I'll take this is what the initial point. From this point only, there will be a two or more vectors. From this point, one vector will move. So I'll just call it this is a vector A. From the same point, again, I'll consider one more vector. That is a B vector. Two or more vectors having the same initial point, then such a vectors are called as a coinsial vector. Is it clear? Next is collinear. Collinear vector. Again, I'll consider two or more vectors. Okay, are said to be collinear if they are parallel to the same line, irrespective of their magnitude and the direction. For example, I'll just consider this is a one vector somewhere here, and the direction will be like this. And I'll consider one more. This is what vector B. Again, from this, one more vector will move. That is B. Okay. So now, A and a D vector. I'll just take it. This is D. Okay. Now, vector A and a vector B, I'll call it as a collinear. Why? Because these two are a parallel. Okay, suppose if you take it like here, I'll take one more vector, that is a C, and I'll take this is E vector. Now the direction will be like this, and this is what the initial point. Now there are how many vectors are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vectors are there. In this, vector A, vector B, vector E are collinear vectors. Why? Because all the three are a parallel, but your direction, it may be anything irrespective of the direction. So these two are in the same direction, but E is in an opposite direction. Even though this E is parallel to these two vectors, hence A, B, E vectors are collinear vectors. Hope you understood this. So next is, equal vectors. Equal vector is nothing but, again I'll consider two or more vectors. Are two vectors I'll consider, vector A and a vector B are said to be equal if they are the same magnitude and direction regardless of the position of their initial points. So then we can say that vector A is equal to vector B. Is it clear? So now, so for this equal vector, I just consider a figure. This is what vector A. Next, from this, I'll consider vector C. And from this, vector B. Vector D. This direction, this and this. From this. Okay. So here vector A and vector B are equal. Why? Because even these two are parallel, again with the same direction it is. Therefore, vector A and B are equal. Is it clear? Two vectors A and B are said to be equal if they have the same magnitude and the direction. Magnitude as well as the direction should be the same, and regardless of the position of the initial points. Okay, it is irrespective of the initial point, but the magnitude and the direction should be the same for these two vectors. Then such vectors are equal vectors. Okay, so next is the negative vector. Negative of a vector. So here vector I'll consider whose magnitude is the same as that of a given vector. If I consider AB, the magnitude will be the same, but the direction is opposite to it. It's called as a negative vector. The thing is, direction is the opposite. Then such a vector is called negative vector, and we can write that is BA. It is opposite direction for AB, right? So hence we can write this AB is with negative sign. So BA vector is equal to minus AB vector. Then such a vector is called as a negative of a vector. So now I'll just go with the examples regarding these. Example 1. So the question is, represent graphically a displacement of 40 kilometer 30 degree west of south. Okay, we need to explain this question graphically. Okay, I'll just go with a map. Map is nothing but east, west, north and south. You need to draw here east. This is what west and this is what east, and this is a north and this is a south. I just take this is the origin point. Now west of a south, west of a south. So from the south it is moving. Now you need to take the displacement is a 40 kilometer from this initial point. I'll just take it the 40 kilometer of this. This is what 40 kilometer. I'll just take it. This is the somewhere the there is a point. Now this west of a south, it make it as a 30 degree for this displacement. It's nothing but we need to represent this angle is make it as a 30 degree. And as the problem is this. Okay, you need to draw it north, south, east and a west. So it is a west of a south, that means from the south you need to take towards the west, and it make it as a 30 degree for the displacement of a 40 kilometer. Is it clear? This is what the solution for the given problem. Now the next example is, we need to classify the following measures as scalars and vectors. Okay, example 2. classify the following measures as scalars and vectors. Is it clear? So now the measures are, first one, 5 seconds. Second one, 1000 cm³. Okay. Third one, 10 newton. Fourth one, 30 km/h. 10 g/cm³. 20 km/s towards north. Now, so here only I'll just classify which one is the scalar and which one is the vector. Okay, so 5 seconds, it is about a time, right? So time is what? It is a scalar. So there is only a magnitude, some real numbers in a time. So hence it is having only a magnitude, there is no direction for a time, therefore it is a scalar. Next is 1000 cm³, it is a volume. So again it is a scalar. So for a volume there is no direction, only a magnitude, like such real numbers. Next is 10 newton. So based on this, it's a unit, you need to write the measures. Based on the measure, you have to write it. So whether it is a scalar or a vector. Newton is nothing but, it is SI unit for a force. So force, we can write it as vector. Okay. Next is 30 km/h is nothing but speed. Again, the speed is scalar. Hope you guys know the definition about these measures, okay? So if you know the measures very well, then only you can classify what type of a measure it is, whether it is a scalar or a vector. Next, 10 g/cm³, it is a density. So density is what? Again, a scalar it is. And last, 20 km/s. Okay, there is a magnitude. Again, there is a direction for this. Towards the north is there. Therefore, it is a vector. Hope you guys understood this. Okay, just read the last one. So if you understood these examples, then the exercise problems are easy. Okay. The question is, in a figure, which of the vectors, are, first one, collinear, second one, equal, third one, coincidental. Okay, so figure is like this. There are 4 vectors, A, B, C and D. So out of these 4 vectors, which and all vector is a collinear, equal and a coincident? So for the first one, collinear. Collinear is nothing but what? 2 or more vectors which are parallel. So irrespective of the direction it is. Therefore, which and all vectors are parallel is nothing but A vector, for this vector C is a parallel. Okay, so again, if you look up with the same line, this is a D, even D is also a parallel to A. Therefore, A, C and a D are parallel. Therefore, these three are collinear. Two or more vectors which are having a parallel to the same line and regardless of or irrespective of their magnitude and the direction. Therefore, collinear vectors are vector A, vector C and vector D it is. Okay. Next, equal vectors. So, equal vector means which is the same as a collinear. That means should parallel and there should be a same magnitude. Magnitude and the direction should be the same. So, in that case, only two vectors you will get it. That is the A and the C vectors are equal. Why? Because these two are parallel. Again, both are in the same direction, which is direction is towards like this. Therefore, these two are a parallel and it is with the same direction. Hence, these two are an equal vector, A and a C. Last one is a coinsial vector. Coinsial vector is nothing but a vector is having a same initial point, then those vectors are coinsial. There's nothing but this, you can take it as a point. So from this point, C is moving towards like this. Then D is moving like this in this direction. Again, from the same point, B is moving like this. So now for these three vectors, the initial point is the same. Therefore, vector B, C and D are coinsial vectors. Okay, vector B, C and D are coinsial vectors. Is it clear? So, if you understood these problems, means exercise problems, then the exercise means worked examples, then the exercise would be easy. Hope you guys can understand the exercise questions and you can solve those questions. Okay, thank you guys.